Alright, so here is my current setup, and what we are going to do is get this to be cleaned up. I just have no room here at all. I got all these wires everywhere, and I got a big keyboard, and I could go to a smaller keyboard, but I really like this keyboard. So the main plan is have a smaller case right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my main gaming and video editing system into the smaller case and move that case over to there, free up some real estate, okay? And the system that is in this already, we are going to put in this case. And in this case, I can kind of tear apart and semi-modify to where it'd make a really nice test bench to run like benchmarks for hardware, run like there's like some weird program I might want to try or something. I can go test that out, and if it like blows something up, I can just wipe and restart everything. So we're gonna set that test bench up with this monitor, since I'm really haven't been utilizing two monitors as much as I really ought to. We're gonna set that up probably over here, so I can use it anytime. Also, it can be a little backup, little gaming system if somebody wants to come over and play a league or something like that. So, yeah. So let's go ahead and get to what tools I might be using for this. Screwdriver, wire cutters, terminal wire connectors for a baby project, I guess, with a sub project. Always use zip ties for everything and everyone. A flashlight, just in case. A drill, because I don't know when I might be drilling something. To keep things clean, I got leftover duster stuff. A knife. All right, so as far as parts that we got for specific upgrades of the systems and stuff, for the smaller case is not a newer sort. And it's not on the high end, so what I went ahead and got a USB 3.0 hub. Thing is, with a smaller case, it's just it sucks for cooling. So I mean, at least for me, so I went ahead and got this hard drive cage thing. And I took the actual hard drive cage out, and it has active cooling on it. It's actually filtered, and it's kind of cool and everything. So what I went ahead and I went ahead and took off the cage, and this will fit in two 5 1/4 inch slots, so I have a little extra airflow coming into the case. And also I got filters because it's cheaper case, and cheaper cases normally don't come with filters, so I got an assortment of filters. For the test rig going into the test bench system, I went ahead and found this beauty on Craigslist for $100. This is a GTX 750 Ti. Let's go ahead and go through each one of the systems. This is the AMD system that is in the smaller case at the moment. It is using a FX 4300 for the CPU, MSI 760G and P34 case, version 4. Mouthful. Right. Storage-wise, we're using Toshiba 1 TB. We also have a optical drive. I don't know what it is. It's just a cheapy optical drive. The power supply is a. It says TurboLink on it. I guess it's made by TurboLink, but it's just a cheapy 500-watt power supply. It has a graphics card, if you want to call it that. It is a GT 610 from MSI. This is actually a pre-built system from CyberPower, or iBuyPower. Is it CyberPower?
Cyber.
Okay, from CyberPower. All right, here is my main gaming video editing system. I guess start off, we got 4670K for the processor. It's an i5 from Intel. That's on a Z87 Maximus 6 Hero. Motherboard from Asus. Cooling the CPU is a Zygmatek. I literally got it because it said Dark Knight and I like Batman. Graphics card is a EVGA GTX 770. It's the super clock edition, so it comes a little overclocked already off factory. For a power supply, it is a Seasonic 860 watt with the 80 plus platinum efficiency rating. For storage, I have a 500 gig internal SSD,
external Western Digital 2 terabyte hard drive. Got a little Asus optical drive just because I'm one of those cavemen who used to use optical drives for stuff. This case is the Cooler Master Half-X Evo. I'll be utilizing the hot swap bays for the test system. Oh, and always with the purple fans. I like purple. So I guess without further ado, let's go ahead and get swapping out these systems. SSD. I'm gonna use this as a template, drill holes for this, and screw it onto this piece that we're gonna install into it. So. This piece does not fit with the bezel very well, so now I'm going to use this Dremel and sand off some of the sides and make it fit a little better. So, here we go. So the fan up in the front on that little kind of hard drive case where we mounted the SSD to, that is a Molex powered fan, but I have this little plug from a fan hub. It's a 12 volt SATA. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try this out, and we are going to snip these wires, put them together. And hopefully we can convert it to SATA so I don't have to run any more cables than I have to. So let's do this. Okay.
Everything's hooked up?
Yep.
You want to hook it up to a monitor? Make sure it posts?
Nope. Oh, wait. Ha!
Oh, that scared the crap out of me.
Alright. Hey, it works! Awesome. Let's go get some pizza. How about that? I'm hungry. Let's go pizza up and then we'll come back and finish.
Okay, so we got the first system pretty much done. Now we're going to build the next system. This one should be a lot easier, a lot less kinks. It's a bigger case, and also we're going to keep the case pretty bare. This is going to be a pretty open air build. So yeah, let's go ahead and get started. Some screws that worked. That's all I'm gonna say. We got both systems going, they both booted up, so that's good. So I guess all that's left is the benchmarks, and they will be up on the screen once I'm done jabbering. So thanks for watching the video. I'd like to thank Beth and Ethan, my two very close friends that came and helped me film and do cable management and just help me clean up my workspace area. So thanks guys. Amen. Thank y'all for watching the video. If you liked it, like it. Hated it, dislike it. I couldn't care less either way. You guys, y'all have a great day. Here are the benchmarks.